الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، continuing on in our series, talking about some of the athar of the Salaf al-Saleh, رضوان الله عليهم, talking about the fadl, fadl al-mawt ala sunnah, meaning the superiority of dying upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I want to make this, this is specifically or particularly relevant to the context of the time that we're living in, when we have so many people who are outwardly, openly leaving the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we have many of them yantasib al-ilm. Some of them, they even are considered people of knowledge. Okay, people who have studied. People who have studied in various institutions in the Muslim world. And people who others consider them scholars and so on and so forth, leaving the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam openly, thinking that they've reached a level of knowledge they no longer need the scholars. They've reached a level of knowledge they no longer, they can philosophize themselves into a new era and a new understanding, a new way, a new madhab, a new minhaj. But listen to how the Salaf al-Saleh were. And that's why we're going to continue on in this series with these short reminders. Listen to this beautiful athar. Yaqul Umar to Ibn Zadan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala. He said, Qala li Ayyub, Ya Umara, Iza kana rajulu sahib sunnatin wa jama'atin, Fala tas'al an ayyi halin kana fihi. So he said, Umarata ibn Zadan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala. He said that Ayyub said to me, إِذَا كَانَ الرَّجُلُ صَاحِبَ سُنَّةِ وَجَمَاعَةٍ فَلَا تَسَلْ أَنْ أَيِّ حَالٍ كَانَ فِي. Meaning, he said, O Amara, if a man is a صاحب sunnah, meaning from Ahl sunnah, you know, they're following the Salafi madhab from the Salaf al-Saleh, وَجَمَاعَةٍ, meaning they don't call to takfir and breaking from the jama'ah, and they don't call to newly invented matters. فَلَا تَسَلَنْ أَيَّ حَالٍ كَانَ فِي. Don't ask about, you know, his status, meaning he got the highest status because he died on the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was known to be an adherent of the book and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning that even if he died on certain sins, and he had some taqsir in his worship, you know, he had some shortcomings in his ibadah, he still was sahib sunnah, and he died upon the correct menhaj, the correct aqidah. He didn't leave the aqidah of Ahl sunnah and go to become Ashari, Maturidiyah, Takfiri, Khariji. He didn't join various groups and didn't come with newly invented ideologies where he's now evolved above all of them. Because now he's at a certain philosophical phase in his life where he's Einsteinized his methodology. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us to die upon the sunnah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.